Hi guys, this is Harsh, and in this video, I will be teaching you how to create an array of objects. But before we get started, if you haven't subscribed to my channel yet, please do so. So I'm using Netbeans for this, but you can use any IDE which you want. So I'll select Java. Then I'll name my class student demo. Great, so here we are. So before we get started, let us discuss a scenario which we will implement in our program. Suppose that we want to store name and age of several amount of students. So what newbies in programming do that, they create two different arrays. One array of data type string to store names of students and another array of data type integer to store the ages of students. So that approach is not preferred. Instead, we can create a class of student that will contain two variables. One that will be name of type string and other will be age that will be of type integer. And then we can create objects of these class and store them in an array. That is what we are going to do in this program. So let's get started. If you need the code for this, you can get it from my blog. I'll leave the link in the description. So let's get started. First of all, I'll create a class student1. This class will contain two variables, name of type string and age of type integer. To make things easier, while I create objects of class student1, I want to assign values to these two variables, name and age. So what I'll do is I'll create a parameterized constructor of this class, and this constructor will get these two values, name and age. I'll pass it when I call this constructor, and this constructor will assign these values to these two variables. So I'm using this keyword for that. Okay, so we are done with this class. Now we'll create this class. If I write int 4. This piece of code will create an array that will store integer values. But now, as I want my array to store objects of class student1, what I need to do is I'll have to write student1, the name of my array, that is students, equal to new, and specify the size for my array. So what this piece of code will do is it will create an array and this array will store address references of objects of class student1. You'll understand it when we go further. So now, when I write, what this piece of code does is I'm calling this parameterized constructor and I'm passing two values. Harsh and 21 to this. And these two values will be stored in these two variables, name and age. And I am storing address of this object in this block, that is this one. So by this code, what will be done is, name will get a value Harsh. And age will get a value 21. So this piece of code creates a new object of class student1 and stores Harsh and 21 in these two variables. And I'm assigning address of this object in this block, students0. So similarly, I can assign all the blocks of this array with different objects. So this will create different objects, store values in them, and assign their address to these blocks. And when I want to print this array, I'll create a for loop for this. So what this for loop will do is, it will print all the values that we stored here. So this block contains address of this object, but this object has two values. So I need to use the dot operator to access each value, that is name and age. I hope you get it. Now let's run this code. Yeah, see, we are getting proper output. So I hope you understood how to create an array of objects. If you think that you have learned something, please like my video and subscribe to my channel. Thank you.